Hey, what's up guys, it's Banana here today with another Destiny 2 video, and in this video we are going to talk about what you should do to prepare for the next Destiny season, because we are coming close to the end of this season. We still got a couple more things. We got the Hawkmoon Heroic Mission so that we can farm those random rolls, and then we also have the High Celebrant coming into the Cryptolith Lure so we can wrap up the story of Season of the Hunt. But we're definitely in a period where a lot of people are looking, and we only have a month left, so they're moving on, seeing what they have to do for the next Destiny season. And this video is just going to be going over everything that I'm doing to prepare, whether it be storing stuff or doing stuff within this current season, because there are a couple things that I would recommend you do before the season ends. But we're just going to get into that. So some of the things that I'm going to recommend here are just something that you should do to prepare for the next season, but some of these are going to be gone after this season, so I'm going to talk about that first, and that's going to be the Crow NPC. There are a couple things you can do here, but there are some pretty good weapons that you can actually farm from the Crow. And you get these from, like, just doing the lures. You've probably seen some of them. But the Friction Fire and the Deafening Whisper are really, really good weapons. And we aren't really sure what is going to happen with them after this season. Right now, it is really easy to just go and farm Deafening Whispers to try and get a good roll. Same with the Friction Fire. You can just go for them over and over in the lure. And maybe they'll still be here next season in the form of world drops, but if you look at something like First In, Last Out, where it was in the Umbral Engram last season, and this season it is just a really rare drop, you don't want to rely on stuff like that. So if you want to get something like a Deafening Whisper or a Friction Fire, definitely farm those out now, because we have no idea how you're going to get them next season. And these weapons are actually sort of good, so be sure to get everything done at the Crow, get those weapons that you want, and be sure to try and finish your lure mods and upgrades. This really isn't that hard to do, and it can help you get the Warden Seal, which is also leaving after this season. So doing every objective on here is definitely going to help you out a lot. If you want to flex your purple Warden name, that's really up to you, but I would recommend getting that seal done and also trying to grind out the best rolls for those weapons possible. My next tip is going to be for anyone who doesn't have their stasis maxed out or still has some of these quests on some of their characters. I have every single stasis fragment. You can see on my warlock if I go and look here. I got all 6 of them. They are really not that hard to get, and you just have to go pick up the quests at the Stranger. But if you don't have all of them and you have been grabbing quests every week, you can actually have an overflow amount of these quests. So you can see I still have 1 extra here that would give me a memory fragment, but I also have 3 memory fragments still in my inventory. So I don't know if they are going to add more stasis fragments, but it would make sense for them to do it, and it would make sense for them to add more aspects and just a lot of things throughout the season that sort of add to our mastery of our new subclass. So if you can get any of these extra memory fragments, it might actually be helpful down the line. I'm not really sure. This one is sort of speculatory, but honestly, it's better safe than sorry, because if there are new fragments and I can get 4 of them off the bat because I have 4 of the currencies, that is going to be awesome. So if you have the opportunity to do that, once again, you do need to not have all 6, because I can't grab any more quests on any of my characters, because it's like, okay, you have all of the memory things, so you're good. But if you don't have all 6, try and get some excess quests in there. Try and grab some within the coming weeks, and don't finish them all until you have an amount of quests that you really want. I don't know how many fragments you really would want to store up, but definitely that is a good way to save some currency and maybe get a head start with some of the new stasis stuff next season. Next up, we're going to talk about one of the most controversial things in Destiny. Some people love it, some people hate it, and that is bounty saving. Bounty saving is something that historically the top players have always done, because this is something that's pretty much just going to carry your XP in your season pass, in your artifact at the beginning of a season. It's going to make it way easier for you to do a lot of things and to just get through in the season pass, because a lot of people don't really want to do bounties for a whole season, so saving them up beforehand is really helpful. You do want to try and save the weekly bounties, so right now you want to get going as fast as possible on grabbing some of these, because some of these are on a bit longer rotations, and it is only once a week that you can grab these. So you look at something like the Varix bounties, they're going to be based on whatever Empire Hunt is there. So he actually has a couple more bounties than some of these other vendors do. And you want to make sure that you're able to grab every single one, and you want to not turn them in until you are ready for next season and you're leveling up your season pass. So saving bounties is really nice. Also, another thing, Iron Banner is coming next week slash this week, however you want to see it. And Iron Banner bounties can give pinnacles to players, and those historically have been able to go into future seasons. So that's something that you guys might want to debate. If you're already at 1260 or at least close enough, you could maybe save your Iron Banner bounties on your character for not only a large amount of XP, but also a pretty good boost to your power, because those pinnacles are gonna come in clutch just getting four extra. So yeah, save your bounties. Next up, materials. Yes, you are gonna want to save materials. As always, for any new season, you're gonna have new stuff to masterwork, you're gonna have new stuff to infuse, so you want to go and you want to grind your nightfalls out, you want to, or do whatever you do to get materials. Nightfalls are by far the most optimal way to grind them out. Like, look at these enhancement prisms and shards that I have, and that's pretty much all just from nightfalls right now. So grinding those out is definitely going to be worth it, because if you get a new drop of armor, you're for sure going to not want to put in a lot of time after the fact. And if you're doing nothing right now, why not get these materials? Doing master nightfalls is by far the best way to get these. If you have a really easy grandmaster on the week, maybe you can do that as well, because grandmasters are also really nuts for getting things. But definitely try and get some cores, try and get some prisms, get some shards, just start gaming right there, because you're gonna want a lot of these when a new season releases. One thing I feel like a lot of people neglect when going into a new season is Glimmer. Glimmer is a currency, and everyone has a lot of it towards the end of a season, because you're really not spending your Glimmer on anything. So you just start stockpiling a lot of it, and most people don't really think much of it. But saving Glimmer is actually something that is really helpful. It helped me out so much in Beyond Light, because the amount of Glimmer I've spent this season is absurd. But saving Glimmer is something really awesome to do. There are a couple optimal ways to do it. You're pretty much going to go in your collection and you're going to go to your equipment. A lot of people have this. I do not. In Season 3, I believe it is, there is the Zavala's Authority. I had this on PlayStation, but since then I moved to PC, I do not have that ship. That is going to be the most effective way to store Glimmer. You basically buy the ship and then you will delete it later. Just throw it into your vault to keep the Glimmer in there. But the other optimal ways to do it are going to be, again, in Season 3 for some reason, the Other Side Sparrow and the G335 Ansurus Overdrive Sparrow. The Other Side costs 7,500 Glimmer and 5 Legendary Shards. I'm just going to buy it right now to show you guys. And then if we delete it, you're going to see that we're going to get, I believe, 5,000 Glimmer and 5 Legendary Shards. Yeah, so we lost 2,500 Glimmer there, but we did end up being able to store it. So if you are at 250k Glimmer, definitely just start buying Sparrows. I've been trying to do this for the whole season just so I can keep some stored up at some point. Whenever I hit max, that is just what I do. So you guys should definitely get going on that too, because Glimmer is a commodity that a lot of people take for granted. And when you run out of it, it really sucks to go try and farm it. So with this season ending, I really think we're not losing too much. We're losing what, like Wrathborn hunts and the weapons from there. And that's pretty much all. The majority of this season has been pretty lackluster. Beyond Light and everything that we've gotten from there is awesome, but the raid is still going to be around for the future seasons, and we're still going to have a lot of the things that were added to the game in these future seasons. So I really wouldn't worry too much about farming rolls. If you want to go for something like a God Roll Heritage or other raid weapons and stuff like that, go ahead, because it is going to be worth it in the long run to have these kind of weapons. But you can still go back and farm these in Season 13 and onward. The only thing that is not going to be very easily farmable is that Deafening Whisper and that Friction Fire. Those weapons are pretty good. I definitely think Deafening Whisper is one of the better weapons in the game. If you're able to get Ambitious Assassin and something like Wellspring on it, it is definitely a force to be reckoned with, so I'd recommend going and grinding that weapon out. But otherwise, you really don't need too many things for this next season. Everything here is just sort of preparing. You want to store materials, you want to get things ready. There's actually a website that I'm going to recommend right now to keep track of all of your stuff. You can log in with your bungie.net, and it's actually called destinyrecipes.com. So this website's basically going to give you a pre-seasonal checklist, and it's really nice. This is a really good checklist. Some of these things are just recommendations by them, like these Vanguard tokens and Crucible tokens aren't really too important, but you can fool around with the numbers yourself. It shows you all the bounties that you can store up. This is a really, really nice website to just check how good you are on your preparation. It even gives you a score based on how it thinks you are doing overall, but this is a really good website. I would recommend it for anyone who is going into a season and wanting to do well, just to keep track of how effectively they are spending their time and getting the materials, because if the game says you're good with Glimmer on here, then you can probably move on to something else. But that's pretty much going to be it for this video. It is definitely fun to prepare for seasons, so I'd recommend that people go and do it. And if you have any other ways of preparing for this next season that I didn't mention, please leave a comment down below. I'm really interested to see how you guys are getting ready for this next season. I'm really hyped to see how it is. And that's going to be it for today. I hope this helped you out. If it did, smash that subscribe button. And yeah, I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Peace out.